numerical relations which are available in our data book also. Coefficient of friction. So the coefficient of friction is having a good importance in the design of hydrodynamic journal bearing, right? Because the entire functioning or the working of hydrodynamic journal bearing is moving around this coefficient of friction. So coefficient of friction is given as mu is equal to 33 by 10 to the power of 8. 33 by 10 to the power of 8 into Zn by P into Zn by P into D by C into D by C plus K, small k. Capital K is bearing modulus, small k is the factor consider for the compensation of L by D ratio, right? So 33 by, this is a standard empirical relation, 33 by 10 to the power of 8 into Zn by P. So what is Zn by P here? Bearing characteristic number. This is inverse of diametral clearance ratio, and K is the factor. K is the factor which is generally equal to, and this factor depends on L by D ratio. That is a factor to compensate for end leakage, depends on L by D ratio, right? K is equal to 0.002 if L by D ratio, right? L by D ratio ranging from 0.75 to 2.8. Right, so these are available in our data book also. Okay, now here the units are more important. If viscosity is in terms of SI units, kg meter second, kg per meter second, or newton second per meter square. Similarly, bearing pressure is in terms of newton per mm square. Then you will get 10 to the power of 8 here. If these are in terms of CGS units, right? If it is in terms of dyne second per centimeter square or newton per centimeter square P, then you will get 33 divided by 10 to the power of 10. Both the equations are available in our data book, right? So the operating values of Zn by P should be considered here, and D by C anyway calculated from your given data, right? Then next one is critical pressure or the minimum operating pressure. Critical pressure or minimum operating pressure of the bearing. So this critical pressure or the minimum operating pressure is designated with the small p, or this is called generally we can look at this with indicate with this bearing pressure. So P is equal to critical pressure or minimum operating pressure is the pressure at which the oil film breaks down. The oil film breaks down so that metal to metal contact takes place between the journal and the bearing surface, right? So beyond this pressure, then you cannot maintain the lubricating oil film. Okay, right? So that's why you can write the equation for this P here, right? You bring this P to this side, then P is equal to, here you will get the coefficient Zn divided by 4.75. into 10 to the power of 10 to the power of 6, right? Into D by C whole square, right? Into L by D plus L. This, okay. So if it is once again in CGS units, then you will get instead of 10 to the power of 6, you will get 10 to the power of 8. Like here, 10 to the power of 10. Here you will get 10 to the power of 8. So this is critical or bearing critical bearing pressure or minimum operating pressure. Next, another important dimensionless number which is used in the design of hydrodynamic journal bearing is Sommerfeld number. Sommerfeld number. Sommerfeld number. Right, so this is generally indicated with designated with SN, right? So this is equal to ZN by P into D by C whole square. ZN by P into D by C whole square, right? That is equal to 14.3 into 10 to the power of 6. 14.3 into 10 to the power of 6. Right? So once again, you need to consider the same parameters, same units for Z and P here. If it is in terms of SI units, you will get 10 to the power of 6. If it is in terms of CGS units, you will get 10 to the power of 8. Okay. So next one, heat generated. Next, fourth one is, why the heat generated in the journal bearings? How the heat generation takes place here? Heat generated in hydrodynamic journal bearing. So, due to the metal to metal contact between the journal and the bearing in hydrodynamic journal bearing, when there is a chance of this lubricating oil film thickness gets seized, then heat generation takes place. And this heat generation, mathematically, you can express Hg is equal to mu into W into V, right? So the main cause of heat generation is the friction. That's why the coefficient of friction between the journal and the bearing is considered. W is the load on the bearing, which is calculated from the projected area. Then V is the rubbing velocity between the journal and the bearing. Rubbing velocity is nothing but the pi d n by 60. So this is rubbing velocity. Is equal to pi d n by 60. Right? And this is load. Load W is equal to bearing pressure into projected area. Projected area is the shadow area, L into D. Then this is coefficient of friction. Okay. So once we have these values, you can find out the heat generated. Right? So this heat generated must be carried away by some other means, otherwise the thermal deformation of the journal bearing takes place, right? So that's why you need to consider thermal equilibrium of this hydrodynamic journal bearing. At equilibrium state, the heat generated must be carried away by right at heat dissipation, at heat thermal equilibrium, the heat generated is carried away by the lubricating oil, right? Or the heat generated is dissipated to the surrounding atmosphere, right? And the remaining heat generated other than this dissipated heat it must be carried away by some external means by providing some external lubrication, right? So therefore heat dissipated by the bearing, heat dissipated. Next, fifth one is heat dissipated. Heat dissipated by bearing is equal to HD is equal to CA into TB minus TA. TB minus TA. Right? So this is heat dissipated equation. Right? Where A is ambient temperature or the surrounding temperature. Ambient temperature. Okay, generally the ambient temperature is considered as 27 degrees centigrade. Then TB is the bearing temperature. Bearing temperature, right? And A is the area, projected area. Projected area, that is L into T. And C is heat dissipation coefficient. What is this? C is heat dissipation coefficient. Right? This heat dissipation coefficient is different for ventilated and unventilated bearings. For unventilated bearings, right? If there is no ventilation, right? And there is no proper ventilation, the heat dissipation will be less, and that is equal to C is equal to 140 to 480 watt per meter square per degree centigrade. For ventilated bearings, for well ventilated bearings, heat dissipation will be 490 to 1400 watts per meter, watt per meter per degree centigrade. Right? So for unventilated bearings, there is no ventilation. If there is no ventilation, heat dissipation will be less. So for unventilated bearings, the heat dissipation is less. That's why 140 to 480 watt per meter square per degree centigrade. For well ventilated, if the ventilation is good, obviously more amount of the heat is carried away by the bearing to the surroundings, so that it can stop the thermal dissipation. So that's how heat dissipation can be calculated. So heat generated due to friction, amount of heat generated, in this amount of heat generated, some amount of heat is dissipated, and the remaining heat generated must be reduced by artificial cooling, right? So this TB minus TA, generally TB minus TA is equal to half into T naught minus TA. Half into T naught minus TA, where T naught is the operating temperature of the bearing, operating temperature of the lubricating oil. Okay.